In example 14.1, a model of the Waddell A truss, we're going to look at the in-class version of only calculating three specific member forces. However, it turns out that these have been carefully selected so that in reality with the method of joints, you're going to have to get just about every single one. So this original problem statement you see here that determines the axial forces in each member, well, really, that's going to be the same as this sort of smaller in-class version that we had. So you're going to see in this solution us ultimately get every single member force. Also note here that the geometry of the truss is such that the triangle that you can see over and over used has proportions where 4 on the vertical, 5 on the horizontal, square 41 on the hypotenuse. I come back to that little diagram every single time, but that's one to, when you're wondering about the ratio of things, to take a look at. You will also note here, as just a review, I've included the calculations for the two reactions. The vertical reaction at the left is 125 kips acting up. Vertical reaction at the right at the roller is 75 kips. This should make sense if you were to think about that with the 100 kip load in the middle, that's everything being symmetric is, that'll get split half to either side. And then with the one that's at the quarter point, then you're going to get 3/4 of it going to one direction and 1/4 of it going to the far direction, right? And that certainly gets reflected here in this total net sum that we have. Right? Now, if we were really only with method of joints trying to calculate these three individual members, what I do when I am trying to strategize about how I'm going to approach this problem is to mentally do what I have down here at the bottom. And that is I have mentally constructed a little feedback diagram of each and every joint as I'm beginning to think about what I can do. And remember, we have, when it comes right down to it, at each and every one of those joints, we have concurrent force systems. Right? And in 2D, that means that I have some forces in the X and I have some forces in the Y at each and every joint. That means I can only solve for two and only two unknowns at each and every joint. And when we take a look at these members that we were after, well, that was the one in here, vertical there, and the other diagonal here. When I look at each and every one of those joints, I get more than one unknown. So I can just go to that joint and be done with this. Then I have to take multiple steps. And when that happens, what I do is I always start with the easiest. And I come, for instance, and I look at this very simple joint that we have at the far left at A. I've got two reactions, which are both known. I have two unknowns, one of which is perfectly horizontal, the other one perfect is on the diagonal, that is. And so I know I can deal with that one in a pretty straightforward kind of fashion. Same thing with the reaction over here. So I, in my mind, I say, check mark. I know what's going to happen in terms of I can get these two. They now become known. Check to see, can I get what I want real fast? Well, no, I still have 1, 2, 3. Ah, bummer. I can't just do one out here. Oh, but wait a minute. This vertical here is tied to a pretty simple joint, the T joint that's down at the bottom. I know this horizontal, or I can figure it out pretty easily. And so I'll know these horizontals. I don't care that much about those because the vertical equation is going to tell me what this vertical bar is. Okay, so now I could think about I've got, in effect, both of those two forces known. And I could come back and with two equations to get those. Unfortunately, those don't align themselves orthogonal to each other, nor are they parallel or perpendicular to the normal Cartesian coordinate system. So that looks a little ugly and nasty. And that happens to include both of the two that I'm after. Yeah. And then there's the one vertical that we want. That's a big mess because it's connected down here at the bottom. We've got five members coming in plus the applied load. Up at the top, that's simpler, but I don't initially know either of those two diagonals coming in there. That looks like a big old mess. I think I'm going to have no choice but to slug this out. And going back to here, I know something easier. That's simple. This one's simple. This one's simple. That one's simple. And maybe that's what I ought to do as my initial strategy. Now, because this solution is going to get a little bit long, we're going to do this in multiple video segments.